Hey everyone, Justin here. Have you ever noticed that we tend to have certain preconceived notions about jobs? Like, we all probably think that rocket scientists are geniuses. And if I brought up the word accountant, most of you would probably picture a nerd or a math geek. Well, today you're gonna get a chance to meet a public accountant, learn more about this career path, and hopefully somewhere along the way, correct some of the misconceptions some of us may have had about accountants.
I think that people have a misunderstanding that public or that accounting in general is for people who kind of have no personality.
So, are all those misconceptions about accountants untrue?
We enjoy life, we have a lot of fun, and we tell jokes, and we have, you know, great stories we can share. And so not to be thinking or be worried that if you go into accounting, you're just going to be this boring person pushing a pencil around.
Tam even goes so far as to say that the opposite is true, that a lively, quirky personality can flourish in public accounting.
I think it's a great field for anyone with that kind of personality. I just think that you need to decide what works for you.
In fact, Tammy believes that any personality type can find a spot for themselves in the world of accounting.
Private accounting, you can be very staid, very quiet, very shy, and not have a problem at all. If you're going into public accounting, you need to be almost a psychologist, a teacher.
Tammy obviously isn't the quiet, shy type. Nor did she envision herself becoming an accountant after she lost her job with the company that folded, making her a displaced worker.
I was actually a displaced worker. I was in the trucking industry first, and they had asked me what I would go to college for, because if I went to college, they could keep, you know, a displaced worker got a lot of free education at the time. And I just chose it out of the blue, and just because I wanted to learn more about bookkeeping, and I really, really enjoyed the public side of it.
Ironically, Tammy's least favorite subject in school was math.
I would have never, if you'd asked me in high school if I was gonna be an accountant, your answer would have been, are you crazy? I hate math.
Tammy preferred English and social studies. She even performed in drama and choir. But math? Not so much.
You know, I was good at it. I'm a straight A student, but it was not something that I was like, ooh, math problems. It was more of a, oh Lord, I gotta get through 35 of these just to get done tonight.
Despite her disdain for math, there are still many aspects of the subject that Tammy uses daily.
Skills, you do need a good attention to detail. You can be taught some of it, but really the ones who do the best have a great idea of the whole picture, but can nitpick the parts that don't seem to be right.
That attention to detail is one characteristic of a good public accountant. Flexibility is another, as public accountants work with numbers all day in various capacities, including tax returns, business startups, retirements, settling estates after a death, or trading stocks. The numbers must be precise and accurate for each.
So in a public accountant's world, your day you have to be able to change on the fly. You have to be able to vary what's going on, sometimes every half an hour.
The need for public accountants is likely to grow. And as of 2020, almost 1.4 million accountants were employed in the United States. Although accounting requires a bachelor's degree, Tammy recommends a different route.
I would recommend starting with an associate's degree because you can really pick and choose what you like.
From there, Tammy said, you have numerous options. With an associate's degree, you can now perform duties such as recording purchases and expenditures as a bookkeeper. Or you could work in payroll and create and distribute employee paychecks. If you complete a bachelor's degree, there are two main options for accountants: becoming a private accountant, or one who works for a single company, or a public accountant, or one who prepares documents for a number of different clients, ranging from individuals to corporations. And while CPAs, or certified public accountants, may tend to earn more and are generally recognized as experts in their field, Tammy emphasized that working as a CPA may not be for everyone.
I originally wanted to be a CPA because, you know, you love those three little letters behind your title. And then when I found out I would only be practicing in Wisconsin unless I tested in other states, I thought, oh, forget it.
Instead, thanks to mobility laws, Tammy is federally licensed and can operate in all 50 states, except Hawaii. Pay for an accountant will vary based on job and geography, but according to the Bureau of Labor Statistics, as of 2020, the median annual wage for accountants was $73,560, well above the median wage for all jobs. To get started in an accounting career, Tammy highly recommends taking a class or two and then working part-time or interning at a company like hers.
So I do a lot of work with people who are in college that are looking for internships. So they come to my office, they work for us for a season or a part of their schooling. And that helps them determine, am I good at public accounting or is this just not for me and I need to try the private sector because I still love accounting.
Besides that, Tammy also encourages you to work with people, experience life, and do something to help others.
I want to see them either volunteering or getting involved in their community, just because I want to see their diversity and ability to handle people and situations that are not always clean and pretty.
Experience working with others and being able to show empathy are very important for just about any career path. But Tammy said that specifically for a public accountant, someone who works with many different people in different situations, being able to put yourself in someone else's shoes is vital.
I learned really early on in my 2-year degree about listening skills and understanding that people hear things based on their history, not based on how you interpreted it when you said it.
And if you're sitting there thinking that accounting may not be right for you because you don't love math, keep in mind that Tammy hated math in high school. She never even planned on taking any accounting classes in college.
I actually took the classes just because they were offered as part of what I had going on and really, really enjoyed. I had started working as a public accountant assistant while I was in my very first year of college and loved it.
Tammy unexpectedly found a career that she absolutely loves, but she's flexible and possesses a great attention to detail, two very important traits for a public accountant. She also loves letting everyone know that accountants can be a lot of fun and enjoy life. Thank you, Tammy, for helping us dispel some of these misconceptions and for sharing with us your unique journey to success.